Tensions build at the Capitol as lawmakers talk paying for the I-70 bridge repairs.
Another Colorado school shooting. What police have learned about the suspects.
Plus, a Jefferson City woman says she wants justice from sexual harassment in the workplace. This is KOMU 8 News at 6.
Coverage you can count on. KOMU 8 News starts now.
The rain comes and goes. When it will stop, no one knows. Then again, maybe Kenton has the answer. Good evening, everyone. I'm Jim Murray.
And I'm Emily Spain. Thanks for joining us. Lots of rain looks to be in the forecast over the next 30 hours. Let's send it over to KOMU8's chief meteorologist, Kenton Jewicki, for more details.
All right, Jim and Emily, thank you very much. Take a look at our current satellite and radar. We do have quite a bit of cloud cover. Some more sunshine, though, for folks really south of Highway 54. But if we zoom out and look, there is more thunderstorm activity over here in Kansas and eventually in Oklahoma and Texas as well. What we're waiting on is for some development here and actually in northeastern Oklahoma. And that's then going to track towards us a little bit later on tonight. Look at this happen here. You can see as we head towards 1 a.m., it's just getting into our area. And this activity is going to be with some heavy downpours, some thunder and lightning as well. Not looking at much severe weather from this, but some heavy downpours, which could, of course, give us some minor flooding, depending on how long it sticks around, but some heavy rainfall rates, certainly a possibility. Then by 8 a.m., more showers and thunderstorms possibly rolling in. It's going to be fairly isolated in the morning hours. It's not until we head into the afternoon that looks to be pretty put together at this point, and then we're expecting some heavier downpours there, too. Now, we are under flash flood watches still until 7 a.m. on Thursday morning because of the still multiple rounds of showers and thunderstorms we're expecting between now and then. And for your day on Wednesday, not only tonight, again, we're not expecting much severe weather. This is mainly for tomorrow afternoon and evening. We have a chance for not only the flooding, but also strong winds and large hail as well with some of these showers and thunderstorms that will be moving through tomorrow afternoon. So I'm tracking that in my full forecast. Plus, we're taking a look at the weekend when we finally start to dry out. It's coming up.
Okay, thanks, Kenton. 2 weeks after the governor declared an emergency disaster in Missouri, the state said today that flooding has not gotten any worse. KOMU8's Sydney Kalich has an update on what emergency management is doing in the aftermath.
Even though parts of the state are still under a flood warning, here in mid-Missouri, the flooding along the Missouri River has stabilized. The state emergency management agency said that this means the flooding has not worsened throughout Missouri, but it has hit an $8.9 million threshold. However, since the flooding has since stabilized, if more major flooding events were to happen in Missouri, the state would have to file an entirely new declaration, which would add more time to the relief effort.
The stabilization has occurred, so this is not a continuation of the first event. This would be a new event. So we're watching for damages that might be occurring now from river flooding and storms that have impacted the state.
Walker says he's expecting a call at any time now regarding the status of the declaration. He says 4 to 5 counties' damage assessments are still pending because the amount of flood water left is too much to properly assess it. In the studio, Sydney Kalich, KOMU 8 News.
For the first time ever, Missouri's general revenue could potentially pay for road and bridge repairs. KOMU 8's Maverick Alexander was at the Capitol today during the scramble to approve the state budget.
The conference committee met today to go over last-minute budget changes before Friday's deadline. $50 million needed to pay for bridge repairs in Roachport would come from the state's general revenue. Representative Greg Razor says that using this source will solve solutions now but will not help out later.
My concern is, first of all, is that we're using general revenue this time to do it, but what happens 20 years from now? What happens 20 years from now when we still have decaying roads and bridges across the state? And someone says, well, you know, look back at 2019. We've used general revenue before.
Razor believes that that plan would take money away from education in our schools. The budget chairman, Representative Cody Smith, discussed with Razor in committee today that it is too late to take any more action.
This is a temporary solution for a short-term problem and perhaps not the best way to address it on the long-term side of things. And I'm happy to work with you going forward on long-term solutions. But again, this is the 11th hour.
The committee is set to meet tomorrow morning to wrap up the budget for this year before sending it to the House and Senate for approval. In the studio, Maverick Alexander, KOMU 8 News.
Here's what's happening right now. We have new information on the shooting at a Denver area school. The STEM school at Highlands Ranch has lifted its lockdown after 2.5 hours. In a news conference within the past few minutes with the local sheriff, he told reporters that 8 students are injured and some are in critical condition. 2 people are in custody. The Douglas County Sheriff says one is an adult male and one is a juvenile male. He believes they are also students. The public charter school has more than 1,800 students, K through 12. All victims are older than 15 years old, according to the sheriff. Parents are trying to deal with yet another school shooting.
Numb. A little numb. I'm glad they're both okay. It was a while before we knew my son was okay.
That woman's daughter is a senior at the school. This incident happened less than 10 miles away from Columbine High School, where 20 years ago, 12 students were killed in a shooting. A former Jefferson City parking enforcement officer is suing the city. KOMU8's Tatiana Presley is here in the studio with more on why one woman is accusing her ex-boss of sexual harassment.
Lily Real claims she was sexually harassed and discriminated against by her former supervisor, James Buck Wilson. She is suing after what she says was a delayed response from the city. Some allegations include staring at her breasts and buttocks, asking about her sex life, and her photo being placed on a work computer desktop. The city's human resource director told me investigations start immediately after complaints are made. Yet, the lawsuit states Real complained to the city many times. Real's lawyer says Jeff City needs to reconsider its response to these issues.
When you have those policies, they ought to be enforced. And if you don't enforce your policy, then this is what happens. You know, you end up with citizens that have to stick up for themselves because no one else will.
The city's attorney says he is unable to comment on the ongoing lawsuits. In the studio, Tatiana Presley, KMU8 News.
A former William Jewell College student filed a lawsuit against the school located in Liberty. The former student reported she was sexually assaulted by a football player. She says the school didn't do enough to protect her against rape and didn't provide sufficient health care and support. Police have investigated her allegations, but prosecutors have declined to file any charges. The college's spokeswoman declined to comment.
The Greene County prosecutor charged a former Hillcrest High School aide for sex crimes today. 29-year-old Michael Cooper Falls faces 5 charges, including second-degree statutory rape, child molestation, and sexual contact with a student. Falls was fired yesterday after his arrest. Fulton neighbors say not in their backyards. Is Callaway County still trying to buy an old state building?
Plus, here are some of the top students in the state right here in mid-Missouri. Hear from one of them coming up.
And a stationary boundary has really given us different weather across mid-Missouri. In the 60s north of I-70, in the 70s south of I-70. Still, I'm tracking what this means for us for the rest of the weekend. So the weekend and tracking that severe threat for tomorrow after the break.
Track storms wherever you are. Download the free KOMU8 weather and traffic app. Brought to you by University Subaru. To the business owners dreaming of their next expansion. To the newlyweds imagining buying their first home. To the family of 3 who's hoping to make it 4. And to Courtney, who's just beginning to dream. First State Community Bank can help.
We would love to hear your dream, so together we can help you reach it.
First State Community Bank. Success starts here.
Do you want to make a difference? Did you know that Missourians with disabilities experience one of the largest unemployment gaps? Yet 51% of unemployed Missourians with disabilities want to contribute to the workforce and increase their financial security. See their abilities and allow your company to be reflective of all members of your community. Expect quality work, increase job morale, and improve your job retention rate. It's easier than you think. Missourians with disabilities are looking to make a difference for an employer right now.
This week, we'll hit 7,000 episodes.
You seem totally surprised.
And we're celebrating with some of our favorite flashbacks.
Well, that hasn't changed over the years. People like winning.
Weeknights at 6:30 on KOMU8.
Join KOMU8 at Family Fun Fest Wednesday, May 15th at Cosmo Park. Presented by Columbia Parks and Rec, May's theme is Kindness Carnival.
What do people think of when they see that R in Riley Chevrolet Buick GMC? All the relationships that were built by serving Mid-Missouri for over 80 years. Regularly giving the right price and best deals. The way folks rely on them to be ready to service their cars and trucks. With respect. Yes, that R stands for all the reasons why people return to Riley.
Treating our customers like family since 1936.
At Menards, nobody beats our prices on everything for your perfect backyard. The Taylor Patio Set comes with four swivel rocker chairs and a tempered glass dining table. It's $399. Grill, smoke, bake, and more with this Pit Boss 8-in-1 Pellet Grill. Just $579.99. The Canyon Creek Dining Collection seats six with luxurious cushion chairs. It's $599. This 10x12 Concord steel roof gazebo adds shade and shelter to any space. It's $999.98. Plus, a Menards gift card is perfect for Mother's Day.
Save big money at Menards.
Mid-Missouri's go-to source for Sealy and Tempur-Pedic, Baumgartner's, in Avaaz and Columbia.
If you've been seriously injured in an accident, visit lawmissouri.com.
Welcome back. A controversial plan to use an old middle school as the new Callaway County Jail might be on hold, even though a bill that would allow it is moving forward. Today, the Senate held a public hearing for a bill allowing the state to sell, transfer, and release some of its property. KOMU8's Alex Arger was at the Capitol today and tells us more about how one particular property is at the center of it all.
This is Rice Hall. The property used to be a middle school for the Missouri School for the Deaf, but it's been vacant for more than a decade. Callaway County has expressed interest in turning Rice Hall into the new jail. But after hearings, meetings, and more hearings, the possibility is still a point of concern. And some neighbors are speaking up about its potential impact.
After the sale of this land and the conveyance of this land from the state, that the county or some other entity would buy this property and build a jail on the site of the Missouri School for the Deaf, which would essentially be a death sentence to the Missouri School for the Deaf.
Anthony Caviani says he's tried to contact many lawmakers with his concerns, but has only heard back from one. He and others say the jail would change the neighborhood.
It's just not the type of community I want to raise my kids in, knowing that there's a prison right next door.
And today, the bill sponsors seem to agree, finishing the meeting with this comment.
That's an issue that stirred up our community, and I don't think a jail will ever be at that property, in my opinion.
In Jefferson City, I'm Alex Arger, KOMU 8 News.
Even if Representative Fitzwater's bill doesn't allow Callaway to use the land for the jail, there's another Senate bill on the table. It deals specifically with the site of the proposed jail, but that bill hasn't made it very far this session. Kenton.
Well, again, another look here tomorrow. We're going to have these showers and thunderstorms out there. We're tracking that hour by hour coming up.
There are many joys that go along with having children. The first smile, the first word, the first step. But sometimes the first step is seeing Dr. Wilshire at Missouri Fertility.
If you've been trying to have a baby without success, you might need a little help. Whether you need a simple procedure or advanced in vitro technology, our team wants to help you fulfill your dream of having a family.
Missouri Fertility. When family matters, we're here for you.
At Big O Tires, we are proud to honor those who have served our country. Because for all the sacrifices our service members and their families make every day, they deserve our support. Now through May 31st, stop into Big O Tires and receive $10 off an alignment, and we'll donate $5 in your name to Operation Homefront, a nonprofit that serves America's military families right here at home. So come by today for great savings on a tire alignment and help us get back to the heroes that sacrificed so much for our freedom. Big O Tires, the team you trust.
Raise your standards. Raise who you want to be, how you're going to go do it. Be focused. Be direct. Go get your goals. Go get it. Go work. Go work. Go work.
Get your season tickets today at MUTigers.com or by calling 1-800-CAT-PAWS.
The KOMU 8 iPhone and Android news app is brought to you by State Tech. Download in the App Store or Google Play.
A lot can happen in a day. So when you're ready to know more than just what's happening, we'll bring you the voices who can tell you why.
This is All Things Considered.
Listen every afternoon.
I've always been proud to call the Midwest home. I grew up working on my grandparents' farm, so I know what a hard day's work looks like. And you can bet that farming and weather go hand in hand. Storms always mesmerize me, watching them grow over the plains. I wanted to know not only how to forecast them, but how to get it right. Turns out it takes long hours from analyzing developing systems to providing up-to-the-minute notifications, but I love every second of it. That's why I show up every day, ready to take on the storm and provide you a forecast you can count on.
What changed while you were sleeping? What happened since the last time you ate breakfast? Our world is changing every minute, and we'll be there every morning to keep you on top of it.
You're listening to Morning Edition from NPR News.
Listen every weekday.
The First Alert Weather Cam is brought to you by the law firm of Harper, Evans, Wade, and Nettemeyer. We will fight for you.
Welcome back. We have an update on that school shooting out of Colorado. Our sister station in Denver 9 News is reporting that the youngest victim is 15 years old. We've also learned 3 of the 8 injured students have been released from the hospital. Some of the victims, however, are in surgery, according to the sheriff. The 2 suspects are students at the school. That's according to the sheriff as well, and they have not been injured.
Back in mid-Missouri, Boone County's top students were awarded today for their work the past 4 years. Missouri Scholars Top 100 honors the state's best high school seniors. The Missouri Association of Secondary School Principals chose the winners. Qualifications include a 29 or higher ACT or a 19 or higher SAT and a 3.75 GPA. A SOBO co-winner says he had no idea he was up for such an honor.
I don't even know. It was insane. I got a big envelope in the mail, and I was like, oh, that's got to be something kind of cool. And, but yeah, like I said, I didn't really realize the magnitude of it until I got to the ceremony, and I was like, wow, this is amazing.
Other schools with the student winners include Boonville, Battle, Hickman, and Rockbridge.
Storms caused damage in parts of Kansas. Linden got hit by rain, hail, and winds. Power lines came down and a carport was dragged away from a home. The Kansas Highway Patrol troopers think the storm is the cause of a semi-truck overturning. Luckily, no one injured during that rollover.
All right, well, you know, this time of year, average high temperature is about 72 degrees for the next 5 days. Well, we're going to be close to that again tomorrow. Then we're going to go below average. High temperatures only in the lower and middle 60s for the end of this week and into our weekend as well, actually through much of our weekend. But it is going to be drier, so cooler weather, but it is drier weather at that. And we've been a bit above average recently anyway, so we'll have a few days there in the 60s. Otherwise, live death rate, first alert radar, we're just scanning a storm, or actually really just a shower, not a storm, a shower getting through northern Sheraton County at this point, just north of Brunswick. Otherwise, we're looking at 71 in Columbia. You can see a big difference depending on what side of the state you live on, if you're to the north or if you're to the south of that really I-70, but even a little bit further to the south of that. As you can see, it is a bit of a diagonal pattern that's rolling through. And it's not only for us, it's going all the way down into Texas as well. And this boundary is a stationary front, and there's a lot of shower and thunderstorm activity right along the boundary as well, getting over here into Kansas. These are actually reports of tornadoes, and even going down into Texas as well. Multiple reports of tornadoes down there right along this boundary. Now, it is going to also give us some shower and thunderstorm activity a little later on tonight. This is about 1 a.m. You can see some showers and thunderstorms rolling through. That continues as we head into the next few hours as well. Of course, then it'll move out closer to about 4 a.m., 5 a.m., and then some more showers and thunderstorms possible by 8 a.m. Now, we're not expecting any severe weather tonight from this in mid-Missouri, but we do have chances for, of course, heavy downpours and lightning as well, which could give us a renewed flood threat depending on how much of that rain is falling at what rate, at how high that rate is of rainfall, and then also how long it wants to stick around. So still a chance. That's why we have this flash flood watch in effect until 7 a.m. on Thursday morning. Then as we head closer to noon, more showers and thunderstorms starting to push in, and that's really when we're going to be watching for the severe threat on Wednesday. Here is about 3 p.m. You can see this line of showers and thunderstorms does have a chance, not only for the heavy downpours, we're expecting that, but also large hail damaging winds, a possibility that we're watching for too. So certainly stay with us and download the KMU8 weather and traffic app as well. We'll give you alerts whether you're at work or at school, so you know exactly what to expect as that starts to brew up and move in. Then that continues, and as by the end of the afternoon and into the evening, it's going to become more isolated, and the showers and thunderstorms are still possible, but it's not necessarily a line of thunderstorms or anything like that anymore. It's more isolated cells that will be rolling through that we'll still have to watch for. So we are in a storm mode 2 for our afternoon and evening tomorrow. That's on a 0 to 5 scale because we could have some issues, and we want to make sure that you're staying updated with us. Again, the main things we're watching for are flooding especially, and then also strong winds, large hail with some of those storms. Tomorrow can't completely rule out a tornado, but that is certainly the lowest threat that we're watching for. Otherwise, here is Thursday morning. Now, we do have still some showers out there as you head out the door on Thursday, but it's due thanks to a cold front that's slowly going to be sucking some of that moisture out of the air, and then we're going to be much drier for the rest of our day. Still mostly cloudy with a bit of sunshine possible in the afternoon, but drier the rest of the day, and then the cloud cover finally exits on our Friday, and it's going to be cooler, remember, but we're back with mostly sunny skies nonetheless. Now, tonight, temperatures stay very warm. We're down to only about 60 degrees, maybe 61 for the low temperature with some of these showers and thunderstorms rolling through. So heavy downpours might wake up to some thunder overnight as well. 75 then tomorrow. Remember, we have those afternoon and evening showers and thunderstorms with the chance also for the heavy downpours, giving us a flood threat tomorrow afternoon and evening. Also, large hail damaging winds, also a possibility. Then on our end of the week, we are cooling down, 64 on Thursday, 63 on Friday, mostly sunny there though. Saturday, you can see it is mostly cloudy on Saturday. It's a cool day there as well. But there is a 20% chance that we do have some showers and thunderstorms late Saturday night into early Sunday morning, kind of an overnight system as a cold front passes through. But we're then on a warming trend after that with mostly sunny skies to start off next week and highs back into the 70s. Here's your WeatherIQ question for the day, sponsored by Break Time. When was the last time the Mississippi River near Busch Stadium there in St. Louis crested over 41 feet, which it just did yesterday, by the way? When was the last time besides yesterday? 2017, 2016, you know, or 1995?
I feel like it was before 95.
The Merrimack River flooding. I think it was
2017, yeah. Yes. And then before that it was 2016, and then 1995 before that. This is only the eighth time it's been over 41 feet.
Okay, thanks, Kenton. Coming up in sports, the Blues will try to outshine the Dallas Stars tonight.
Game 7 in St. Louis. Time to win or go home.
See it, believe it. The full Hyundai lineup available at Joe Mockins Hyundai. With impressive offers on every Hyundai model, all sold with true upfront pricing. View hundreds of new Hyundais on our big board with prices and discounts clearly marked. Every new Hyundai comes with America's best 10-year, 100,000-mile warranty. And our 3-day love it or leave it guarantee. Worry-free car buying with true upfront pricing. All roads lead to Joe Mockins Hyundai at joemockinshyundai.com.
1023 BXR is what Columbia sounds like. The station where music matters. Music from yesterday and today. And more for your workday with Mo, Simon, and Emily. On air or streaming at BXR.com. Get your BXR app today. 1023 BXR.
Tonight's primetime lineup on KOMU 8 and Mid-Missouri CW is brought to you by your Heart of Missouri Chevy dealers. Find new roads.
Tonight.
It means a lot not to miss these moments.
Come home to the show that has captivated our hearts.
I would like to talk to you at some point. I can't break through.
You're her father.
The Village, new tonight on NBC. Tonight, Max uses every last breath.
This is a public hospital.
People don't even know that they can come to us for free.
To spread a message of hope.
We can give them out to every resident of New York City.
Max, is this the hill you want to die on?
New Amsterdam, tonight on NBC.
We all wish we had a little more time in our day. Time for the important things.
That's exactly what we do at Mark's Mobile Glass.
We save you time, we save you money.
You may not plan for things to break, but we do.
Mark's Mobile Glass does anything glass. Auto, residential, commercial, even custom shower doors.
It's our job to be one step ahead. Whenever you need us, Mark's Mobile Glass is ready to help.
So at the end of the day, you have more time for the important things.
Integrity to me means when you say something, you mean it, and then you follow through. I think it's extremely important, not just in the automobile business, but in any business, that our word is something.
I want to be that, you know, known as that dealership that we're the go-to place, that we're going to take care of you.
That's something that's very important. A lot of dealerships still don't recognize that. They try to see if they're trying to get the low-hanging fruit.
For me, it's about being up front with everybody that comes to the dealership, everybody that calls, everybody that emails, is that we're going to be completely up front on everything.
Now, from the Ford Sports Desk, K KOMU 8 Sports.
Hi, everyone. Game 7 tonight between the Blues and Dallas Stars. The puck drops at 7 o'clock at the Enterprise Center in St. Louis. What a series this has been. The divisional rivals tied at 3 games apiece with the road team winning each of the last two. The key to the game tonight could indeed be the play of Big Ben Bishop. The Dallas goaltender and graduate of Chaminade Prep in St. Louis took a puck to the neck in Game 6 Sunday and left shortly thereafter. We'll see how he is tonight. When he's been on, he's been really good. The winner tonight advances to the Western Conference Finals to play San Jose or Colorado. Game 7 of that series is tomorrow night. The Mizzou softball team will play Auburn tomorrow afternoon at the SEC tournament in College Station, Texas. First pitch scheduled for 3 o'clock. A pair of Tigers are recognized by the SEC for their play. Sophomore outfielder Brooke Wilmus earns first-team All-SEC honors. She's the first Tiger to earn first-team All-Conference recognition since Emily Crane in 2016. Wilmus led Mizzou in hits, doubles, triples, and batting average. She batted .357 for the season, had a better mark in conference play at .366. Meanwhile, shortstop Jasmine Rowland made the SEC All-Freshman team. She scored 40 runs and stole 16 bases. She also became the first Tiger to hit 10 or more homers and steal 15 or more bases in a season since 2016. It is the final week of the high school baseball regular season before the district playoffs begin. Hickman is hosting Southern Boone County, and the visiting Eagles lead 5-2 in the sixth. Meanwhile, Hallsville has its final home game of the season against Sturgeon. Right now, the Bulldogs lead the Hallsville Indians 2-1 in the fifth inning. Highlights of those games for you at 10. At the Major League level, the Cardinals look to make it 2 in a row over the Phils at Busch Stadium, while the Royals try to even their series in Houston. We'll show you highlights of the Cards and the Royals at 10. Busy night of sports shaping up, but for now, that's it.
What do people think of when they see that R in Riley Toyota? All the relationships that were built by serving Mid-Missouri for over 2 decades. Regularly giving the right price and best deals. The way folks rely on them to be ready to service their Toyota cars and trucks with respect. Yes, that R stands for all the reasons why people return to RileyToyota.com.
The Riley Toyota family does it all.
Because nothing's stronger than family.
For the first time ever, make our discount your discount with employee pricing at Denver Mattress. For a limited time, our employee discount is available to everyone. Get 15% off a single Denver Mattress brand product when you spend $9.99 or more. And with our 365-night better sleep guarantee, you'll rest easy knowing you're getting the right mattress. Plus, 2 years, no interest financing. You pay what we pay, only at Denver Mattress. But hurry, employee pricing ends Thursday the 9th.
If you've been accused of a crime and are in need of legal representation, contact the team at Carson & Coyle.
We defend our clients in all criminal matters and are prepared to present your case to a judge or jury.
Our criminal defense attorneys handle the investigation and legal preparation to protect your interests at trial.
It's important to choose an attorney who can guide you through the criminal justice system. For over 50 years, we have built our reputation here in Mid-Missouri with offices in Jefferson City and Columbia to better serve you. At Carson & Coyle, we are dedicated to protecting your legal rights.
2 Mid-Missouri locations. Thousands of vehicles at your fingertips. All in one place. JoeMockinSport.com. 7 days a week on the lot or online. Browse our entire inventory of new and pre-owned vehicles. Get pre-approved for a loan or lease. Receive an appraisal for your trade-in on any device, at any time. Thousands to pick with just one click. JoeMockinSport.com.
It's our biggest Memorial Savings event ever at Missouri Furniture with buy one, get one half off. For the first time ever, buy one item at our low sale price and get your second item half off on all furniture and mattresses. Plus, great financing options. BOGO, 2 items or a dozen. Plus, shop big savings on appliances, spas, and outdoor furniture at the best price guaranteed. Now through Memorial Day, buy one, get one half off at all Missouri Furniture locations. Better quality, best price guaranteed.
Help cool our community this summer with KMU8's Fan Club. Donate a new or gently used fan to any of our 3 drop-off locations. Visit KOMU.com for more information.
Here's the look we're following for KOMU 8 News at 10 o'clock. A video posted online has outraged some Mid-Missourians for what it shows.
What the video is about and whether it's legal tonight at 10. Kenton.
All right, remember, we're tracking some showers and thunderstorms for late tonight, and that's really going to form up over northern Oklahoma and southern Kansas and head our direction. That's arriving after midnight tonight with some heavy downpours. Could hear some of that thunder, too. Otherwise, temperatures different across the state. Colder to the north, warmer to the south. And then tomorrow, we're going to be in the 60s and 70s throughout the day with some passing showers and thunderstorms.
Chris, it's not often when the St. Louis Blues have a chance to go to the Western Conference Finals.
They were there a few years ago against San Jose, who they could end up playing again in a week's time if they both advance. But other than that, you got to go back, what?
The 60s.
Yeah, a few decades. Like.
That is our time for now. Thanks for joining us.
We'll see you at 10.
On air, online, on Facebook.